This is an update in my continuing coverage of KIC 8462852, or Boyajian Star, for September 10th, 2017. Check out the dedicated playlist for this enigmatic star on this channel for the backstory. First, the emergent news. The star has been dipping regularly over the last few months, but now we have something different happening. As of a few nights ago, the star basically has gone into freefall and is on its way down to what appears, though you can never be sure with a star, to be a major dimming event. The first of its type, in fact, since ground observations of this star commenced. In the past, these dips occasionally got very deep in the Kepler light curve, as much as 22%. This one is somewhere between 2.5 to 3% as of last night, and shows no signs of recovery, so may go significantly lower, we shall see. These types of major dimming events are among the most interesting things this star does, because to block that kind of light, you need truly massive objects or structures of objects to do it, in this case several times the size of Jupiter. In the description below, I have placed three links. The first is to the official website of the science team investigating the star, though there are a whole lot of other people looking at this one. In the blog section on that site, you'll find daily updates of the light curves of the star posted by Dr. Boyajian, should you wish to monitor it in real time. These are taken by two separate observatories each night, both in different areas of the globe. The funding for time on these telescopes was originally crowdsourced on Kickstarter, but that was a while ago, so the second link is to Dr. Boyajian's donations page. I would encourage anyone interested in this star to consider a donation, so study of the star with active nightly photometric observations can continue. The third link is to a new paper by F. Kiefer and colleagues. In it, they detail a correlation between two features in the Kepler light curve that might suggest the passage of the same object, specifically a string of exocomets passing in front of the star with a period of just over 928 days. They point out that this could also be consistent with the recent hypothesis that the dimming is due to a planet with a massive ring system. The paper goes on to make a prediction that these exocomets will pass again in October of 2019. As usual, both of these possibilities have problems. In regards to exocomets, there are two. First is Bradley Schaefer's calculation that to cause this effect, along with the long-term variability of the star, you would need a perhaps implausible number of comets orchestrated to pass in front of the star over a long period of time. The other problem is the paper by S. Rappaport and colleagues from a few weeks ago, which made the case that exocomet transits in the Kepler light curve simply do not look like the dips at KIC 8462852. With the planetary ring hypothesis, the problem there is stability and how long such a ring would last. This is unclear, but it may be the case that such a ring would not last long in geologic time, and the chances of just happening to catch it while it was there are somewhat bad. Then again, whatever this is, it's probably safe to say that it's a rare phenomenon regardless of the cause, since we do not see other examples of the star's behavior. At least not yet. One of the things scientists will do in the future when trying to figure out what's going on with this star will be to search for other examples of the phenomenon. If none are found and problems continue to plague any of the explanations out there, then other possibilities will need to be considered, including options related to SETI. But those too come with problems. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently wondering about the snickering aliens again. What would happen if we got a radio signal from Tabby Star that, when translated, came out to fold you and the whole thing was the alien equivalent of a whoopee cushion? And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.